autographed Manson handprint to a Christmas card signed by a San Diego killer. So-called Murderabilia are now up for sale, prompting one local victim's family to fight back. As our Tenders reporter Michael Chen found out, they are weighing legal action aimed at shutting down the websites.
Murder and profit go hand in hand on sites like this one, dubbed a true crime collectible site. Front and center today, anything Manson.
We find it abhorrent.
From autograph stamps to a handprint for $900.
That anyone would profit off someone else's pain.
Lawyer Spencer Busby represents the Van Dam family. In 2002, 7-year-old Danielle Van Dam disappeared from her Sabre Springs bedroom, her body found weeks later. Neighbor David Westerfield later arrested and convicted for her murder, currently on death row in San Quentin.
We searched this website and found two items related to David Westerfield, including a Christmas card signed with an envelope selling for $30.
Another is a drawing of Westerfield with an adult version of Danielle signed by the illustrator, believed to be an inmate. Price tag nearly $200. The site seen by Brenda Van Dam, Danielle's mother.
She found it outrageous, disgusting. Insult to her family.
The Van Dam's now weighing a lawsuit against the site, which we aren't naming, to prevent drawing more attention to it. There are laws preventing profiting from crimes, but those apply to the criminal. But
they don't appreciate people out there making money off the death of their daughter, period.
Busby says they could sue for misuse of Danielle's likeness, inflicting emotional distress and invasion of privacy.
They didn't have to be out there in the news. They're entitled to their privacy, and this is bringing up old wounds.
Wounds shared by other families now seeing their pain for sale.
If there's some way legally we can put a stop to it, we will.
Michael Chen, 10 News.
Busby says a suit could also help determine if Westerfield is somehow profiting from the sales, which could lead to that money being seized. We reached out to the website for a comment, but we have yet to hear back.